sound good. And that's, like I say, one of the few that I've ever made. Now, this old guitar here is one I made, I think, close 35 years ago. And I've been making these things for getting pretty close 50 years now. I've made...
He started when he was 3.
I did start way back there. I started playing when I was 5 because I, you know, and, you know, for something to do, learn how to play music like my family did. But I did get into building guitars because I couldn't afford a good one, you know, and I had an old beat up guitar that had a neck as big as a Louisville Slugger. I'd have to get a G chord like that. I couldn't reach around it. And so that sort of got me into building guitars. But I did make this one like 35 years ago, and it's nothing fancy. But Petey over here has got a picture of one of my real pretty ones. Aww. And she showed me there a while ago. And it's number 400. It's got all kinds of inlay. I've got one of Otto's I might play to you before this set's over here. And it's a prettier one, too. And this one, Helen's played hers an awful lot. It's 10 or 15, 20, maybe 20 years old. I don't know how old that guitar is. And so that's, you know, mainly what I like doing the most of anything. I work in that shop I don't get up real early in the morning, but I work in there till most nights, 2 and 3 o'clock in the morning. And the only reason I quit doing it is because I get so I can't stand up. I get so tired. But I absolutely love building guitars and have done it all those years. I've made, I think, about 500 and, what was the number that last one? 585, I think, or something. And pretty much.
I'd like to put in an order for number 700.
Okay. Well, that's getting pretty ambitious, you know. I'm getting old, but I'd love to be able to make his old Stradivarius. Made, I think he made around 1,100 instruments in his time. Of course, he had apprentices and help and didn't carry the mail for 30 years. I did do that for a spell, but I kept my shop, and I've worked in that shop every day that I run my mail route to. And so I'd have to, if I hustle, maybe I can get 1,100, I don't know. But anyway, I didn't look what time it is. I guess it's getting pretty close to an hour. I think they played a couple of sets and take a little bit of a break, and maybe needs to get something to eat or go to the bathroom or whatever. We can give a little time to do that and hope you'll stay around. This is absolutely wonderful crowd. I'm just telling you about that.
And I want to brag on Kay in this sound.
Yeah,
it is.
The sound
is
wonderful.
It's so good. We were talking earlier about the January crud, which lingers in your throat and your chest, and so I feel like I'm being so careful, and I can hear everything, and I'm trying not to let the frogs have their way.
You're sounding pretty good tonight. This is one of the nicest places, and I don't think I've ever played for this big a crowd where they've got stuff to eat and drink and pay that much attention to us. We really, really appreciate that so much. And that's just absolutely wonderful.
I like her.
Kate's sound is just, I mean, I've even played up there in that fancy place in New York, at Carnegie Hall place. It ain't no nicer than this. Had this wonderful opportunity to pick and sing here in this great venue, and might do a thing here so y'all can perform something and can help us out do this tent. I think I've got my Red Sox cap on. That makes some people mad and gets me in good sometimes. You know? But I've always been a baseball fan, and actually I've got a trip this next month in April, and they want us to go play plumb out in Colorado and Pennsylvania all on the same trip. But I said, if you'll get me into a game at the Rockies and at the Pittsburgh Pirates, I'll do it.
So, yeah.
So we're going to do that, I think. And if you go to a ball game and stay around with about 7.5 innings, I can remember watching baseball on TV when Dizzy Dean was an announcer. Yes. Way cool. Yes. And he would sing Wabash Cannonball. He's a Roy Acuff fan. And he'd do this one sometime. That's what I want y'all to do. It's for, just for me, because I love to hear this. And we're going to do it a couple of times for y'all to sing, and then we'll speed it up and make a guitar instrumental out of the last part of it. So here's your part. Here's your chance to get to play at the Ashland Coffee House. And that's a big deal. For sure. So here's your part. I'll get Otto's guitar and play that on there. And could you feel like singing Freight Train?
Maybe. Well, I'll try.
Try it a little. We'll do another tune and then take a little bit of break and hope you'll stay around because we know some more tunes. We'll do the rest of them we know after. And if you do have to go anywhere, I really appreciate you so much, you know, coming and being such a wonderful audience to play for. I want to play this tune especially for Otto, too. He's helped out a whole lot informing people about us being up here. And
he made a really cool poster that I think he's going to have some available during the intermission. And the smaller poster, it may not be silk screened, but it's really high class because it's got a picture of Spencer, my dog. And he's a really special black and tan coonhound, so I hope you all decide to take a little bit of Spencer home with you tonight. And on Freight Train, I haven't sung this song in 25 years, but I bet there's some of you who have probably sung it 25 years ago too, so help, okay?
Tried to do this tune. Back in way early 70s, the Smithsonian, I've been building guitars for a long time, sent me way up to Montreal, Canada, and it's where they had the World's Fair there in 67, and the Smithsonian took over the U.S. Pavilion. They had a folk festival that ran there for several years, and I got to go one time to demonstrate my craft of making guitars. But there's a whole bunch of cool people in there playing. And one of them was Elizabeth Cotton. And I got to sit and pick with her a little bit. And that's a rare opportunity. And I almost couldn't play with her for watching her play. I don't know if you ever saw her, but she played a guitar strung like this one. And played it upside down and left-handed and did good thumb lick, you know, with her little pinky, or this one, I guess. And it was amazing to watch her play, make that guitar sound so good, and it looked totally backwards, but especially to be playing a guitar that was backwards for her. And anyway, she was wonderful to pick, sit down and play some with me, and I've always appreciated that. And this is a tune she wrote, she told me, when she was 11 years old. She lived to be in her 90s, I think, and so this is an old tune, one called Freight Train. I think every guitar picker from Chet Atkins on down recorded this one sometime or another. So. Show it to you. I guess I'll hold on to Otto's, but you're welcome to play mine, and if you want to, or whatever. And thank you so much. We'll be back in a little bit.